Welcome back to the Proactive Studio. With me now is Kula Gold Managing Director Ric Dawson to discuss the company's projects and today's results from its wholly owned Brunswick project. Ric, nice to meet you.
Good morning or good evening.
It's like that. Ric, before we get into today's news, can you talk me through the company's diversified projects and this year's focus on gold?
Thank you. Yes, last year we were very much more lithium focused. This year we're going to be more gold focused. I think we're not going to, you know, throw the baby out with the bathwater, but we still think our lithium projects still have merit. But we think with the gold price being as strong as it is at the moment, it's worthwhile having a relook at our gold projects.
And you started the year strongly at Kirup and Marvel Loch. Talk us through the work that you're doing there and how those sites are coming along.
Thank you. So we've got a good suite of exploration projects. So we have our Marvel Loch area, which was historically a kaolin area, but we've now realised there's gold potential. We are sitting in the Southern Cross gold fields. So yes, we started off with some soil programs. That's given us some encouragement. We've now done a second round of soils at Boomerang. And so we're very encouraged by that. And in fact, we'll probably look to do a very, very precursory scouting drilling program. But we'll leave that for the market to get the updates of that. And then down at Kirup, we've had a very attractive soil program starting around the Mustang area. Mustang was originally more of a lithium focus, but we've taken ourselves a little bit further to the west, closer to the Darling Fault. And we've started to get some good rock chips. We had a 3.5 grammer, and now we've done a soil program and some more rock chipping, and we hope to have an announcement out about that not into the distant future. So yeah, generally, you know, the golds, we are a company that's very focused on grassroots exploration. We like to think we're good developers and incubators of projects. And so, yeah, we can do it on a very modest budget. Obviously, drilling costs you a lot more. And so, yeah, so we're very attractive. We're very, very happy with the progress we've made so far this year.
And you've made progress again today. So it's a good time to be speaking with you at the Brunswick project. You've had some results from there. And what are you seeing at the Camilleri prospect?
We're very attracted to the area. It's been a known historically area for gold. Sometimes general companies tend to be a bit more tunnel visioned on certain areas. So we were very much trying to see who hasn't looked at certain spots. And this one particular area, the Camilleri, it's got good grade, good production historically, and very underdrilled for an area that's got such good, rich grade.
What are the key points of the announcement today?
Well, I think the key points are that, you know, you've got an area which had historically a very attractive grade production, nearly 146 grams per tonne, which, you know, in this day and age is unheard of. That's one attraction. Secondly, we've had some rock chipping in the area, which is giving us confidence that at the surface, there's definitely something of interest. So, yeah, we want to start thinking about, you know, RC drilling in the not too distant future.
So you've got lots of work going on, and it's, as you mentioned before, it is a good time to be in gold at the moment.
Yes. Yeah, no, the gold market, I think, for the last couple of years, it hasn't been the darling. Lithium was all the go, rare earths were the go. I think people are starting to realize gold in US is 2,300 or thereabouts. So in Aussie terms, it's over $3,000 an ounce. So there's some very good profits to be made at that sort of level.
And the coming news flow, Ric, what can we expect to see from the company in the coming weeks and months?
Coming weeks and months, I'd like to think that we'll probably have three or four announcements over the next month. We're starting to get some results coming through from those early soil programs and rock chipping programs. So, yeah, I think there's a fairly good news flow over the next month. So that's attractive for the market. I think also the fact that we have a market cap, which would normally be classed as shell value, You know, we're 3 million market cap at the moment, and I couldn't buy one project for that sort of dollar value at the moment, let alone all the suite of projects we have.
So certainly a bit of upside there, Rick. What's the overall investment case?
The investment case is, we, you know, we're a company capped at $3 million. We have a tight share register. We've got a very experienced board. We are very careful with our money. I think, yeah, any shareholder should see some upside based on these current prices.
Rick, we look forward to seeing what's to come, and thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.